أجمعين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا رحمة للعالمين. My honorable elders, brothers, dear children, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It is proven from many authentic narrations that indeed is a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when someone sits in a majlis, in a gathering in which Allah ta'ala is remembered. People remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they do the dhikr of Allah and about his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So indeed, it is a blessing for us that this time that we're going to spend here listening to one of the noblest ones who has walked the earth. Indeed, it's a blessing and a rewardable act. And these moments are going to be spent only on the Day of Judgment. We will realize the value of these moments spent in the house of Allah. So we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the effort that has been made for us, though, that we have come here with the tawfiq of Allah, may Allah ta'ala accept our attendance and make this a reason for our salvation hereafter. Allahumma ameen. So as per our tradition, to start the program, I would like to invite Hafiz Muhammad bin Zahid, who is a graduate of our masjid, to come and recite a few verses from the Holy Quran. Narai takbir. نراي تكبير نراي رسالة إسلام إسلام
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله قلتم إلى الأرض أرضيتم بالحياة الدنيا من الآخرة فما متاع الحياة الدنيا في الآخرة إلا قليل إلا تنفروا يعذبكم عذابا أليما ويستبدل قوما غيركم ولا تضروه شيئا والله على كل شيء قدير إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم انفروا خفافا وثقالا وجاهدوا بأموالكم وأنفسكم في سبيل الله ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون لو كان عرضا قريبا وسفرا قاصدا لاتبعوك ولكن بعدت عليهم الشقة وسيحلفون بالله لو استطعنا لخرجنا معكم يهلكون أنفسهم والله يعلم إنهم لكاذبون صدق الله العظيم.
Such a beautiful recitation by Hafiz Muhammad bin Zahid. May Allah Ta'ala bless him. Allahumma ameen. Now for a few couplets of Nas Sharif in the Bargah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I invite Allah Hafiz Amin for God Ahmad Sahib to come along. Narai Takbir, Narai Takbir, Narai Risalat, Islam, Azmat Sahaba.
Sallallahu alayka ya
exists in this universe is a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah
Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran that the best amongst his creation, that whatever he created, human beings are best amongst his creation. لَقَدْ خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. The mafhum, the understanding of this verse is that amongst Allah's creation, the best is human, are humans. Amongst human beings, the most honored and noblest are the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the most, the best amongst the prophets and the messengers, alayhi salam, is our master, son of creation, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is our firm aqidah and yaqeen and believing that there is no messenger, no Rasul or Nabi to come after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the messengers, the most noblest individual is Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. أفضل البشر بعد الأنبياء بالتحقيق with authenticity and all the ulama of the past, the prized predecessors and the faith have agreed upon this fact, and this is our aqeedah. Now one more thing before inshallah we pass over to Imam Sahib. Allah Ta'ala gathered all the messengers before he created this universe and he said to them, I'm going to send you with a mission. And you've heard this verse so many times before, the understanding of this verse. If during your time of Nabuwa, my final messenger comes, or my messenger comes, he's supposed to be final, then you're going to give up your mission and you're going to follow him. Here Allah Ta'ala is setting a standard amongst all his prophets, the maqam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is being set even Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam is sent to this earth. Now think about that person who supported Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the day Allah Ta'ala gave the Quran to him until Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went away from this world. Indeed, and this is our aqeedah and should be, that also Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was chosen by Allah even before the creation, even before man was created. That Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala will be the Siddiq of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the maqam of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And what makes him the noblest and the best amongst mankind after the prophets and messengers, this is inshallah what we will be learning and hearing from Janab Imam Muhammad Ahmad Thamar Arshad Sahib. So without further ado, I request Imam Sahib to come along and inshallah with that beautiful word deliver to us an elaborative bayan about Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Narai Takbir! Narai Takbir! Narai Risalat, Islam.
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والذي جاء بالصدق وصدق به شأن حبيبه مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون يكون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. رب ديار ديار صديق رب ديار ديار صديق هم سب دادل دار صديق رب ديار ديار صديق هم سب دادل دار صديق. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. All praises to Allah Azza wa Jal. Salutations be upon the best of creation, the merciful for the worlds, Sayyidina Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon his returning and glorious companions. Alhamdulillah, we are gathered here today to talk about someone who is so special, so special that he is known as Afdalul Bashar Ba'd al Anbiya, the best, the most virtuous, the best of people after the Prophet The reason that we come here and gather together and to learn about such individuals is so that we can actually take them as our role models. And that is one of the main purposes, so that we can learn something from their lives and actually implement it in our own lives. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the companion of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the best friend of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the one who was closest to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam from his companions, the first person to accept Islam, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the first person who prayed with the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, it's mentioned that the first person who preserved the Quran was Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The person who first memorized the Quran was Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And the person who will enter into Jannah from the Ummah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first is also going to be Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now there are so many virtues of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala that we can mention. So many qualities of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala we can mention. Time is limited, so only a few things inshallah that I'm going to mention that we can inshallah ta'ala implement in our own lives as well inshallah. And again, that is the true purpose of Mahafil, that we can learn who these individuals are, how the ranks are so high, what's the reasoning behind it, and maybe then we can implement some of those things in our lives as well. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the closest friend of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu is that individual when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was talking about the doors of Jannah. Jannah, it has 8 doors. And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was talking about the door of Jannah. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala and he asked, Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone who will enter through all the doors of Jannah? And the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Yes, and I hope that will be you, O Abu Bakr.
Subhanallah.
It's the shan of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. One day Sayyidina Aisha as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anha, she held the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in her lap. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is resting. And so she looks at the stars and she asks, Ya Rasulullah, is there anyone whose good deeds are like the stars? Are as many as the stars? And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala replies, just with the question, I want to bring your attention to this. Do you know anyone, Ya Rasulullah, whose actions are equal to the stars? Saying the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has the knowledge of how many stars there are. Now if you just think about it, how many galaxies there are. Science and technology, we cannot understand and we cannot count the number of how many stars there are. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows how many stars there are. How many stars Allah azza wa jalla has created. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also knows the actions of his ummatis. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows the actions that the people that are from his ummah, they do. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows this. And so knowing this, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Umar bin Khattab, Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, she becomes a bit upset. And this is a sign of love as well. This is a sign of love that you want those people that are beloved to you, those people that you love, you want their names to be mentioned. You want their names to be mentioned in every good. So Sayyidah Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha, she's a bit upset that my father's name was mentioned. And so she asked, Ya Rasulullah, what about my father? What about my father? And so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all of the good deeds of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, all of the good deeds of Umar are equal to the deeds of one of the deeds of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. So all those deeds of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, how many they are? Allah and His Messenger know. Allah and His Rasul know. All those deeds of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala equal to one of the deeds of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. What is the rank of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq? How high is the rank of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala? أفضل البشر بعد الأنبياء. The best individual after the prophets and messengers salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi wa jma'in. This is Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And then we wonder, how did Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala get his rank? How is his rank so high? And the ulama kiram, they mention two things. And one of the very things that they mention is suhba, the companionship of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That even before him announcing Islam, he was a friend of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was the best friend of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never bowed to any idol before he accepted Islam. He was a pure individual. And he would spend his days with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is prior to Islam, the announcement of Islam. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala was the best friend of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the narration that if I was to choose anyone to be my best friend from the creation, I would choose Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. This is Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And so from this we also learn the importance of friendship. The Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and who was his friend? The best of creation, Sayyidina Muhammad al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so because of that friendship, because of that love, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, he reached ranks upon ranks upon ranks upon ranks. And so this is something that we should stress upon, especially with our children. That companionship, have good company, have good friends. There is a verse of a poem in Farsi, which says Sohbate Salih Tura Salih Kunad Sohbate Talih Tura Talih Kunad. The good Sohbah, good friendship, it will eventually turn you into good. It will make you good. And bad friendship will eventually corrupt you. It will make you bad too. And the example which is normally given is the example of someone who works in a blacksmith shop. He's not doing any of the work the blacksmith is doing. He's just lingering around in the area. He comes back and good company, like a person who's entered into a shop which sells fragrance. And he hasn't put any fragrance on. He just lingered there for some time and he's come back out. But you can still smell some fragrance on him. And this is the effect of friendship. That friendship, it does have a massive impact on our lives. Who we make our friends. So we should be very careful on who we make our friends. And who we choose to be our company. And this is a question that we should ask ourselves as well. If someone was to look at us, would they see us as good company? Or would they see us as bad company? And if we are seen to be those who are bad company, we should change ourselves, make ourselves better. To be good company and to sit in with the people who are good company. To sit with the people who are good company. Sit with those people who are pious, so that we may become pious as well. Friendship does have an effect. And how did Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala gain this title of as-Siddiq? Inshallah ta'ala, in the coming weeks, you will be learning about the night journey, the Mi'raj. And you will be hearing regarding the Mi'raj. Now what the Mi'raj was? The night journey where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam traveled in a short period of the night from Makkah al-Mukarramah to Bayt al-Maqdis, from there to the seven heavens, and even beyond that to a place called Lamaka. Inshallah, you're going to be hearing about this. But when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam returned back from this journey, he told the people about the journey that he went. And the kuffar, they were questioning and they were saying that, how is that possible? How is that possible that you went all the way to Jerusalem, which is a month's journey there and a month's journey back? How is that even possible that you went there in a part of the night? So what they do is they rush towards who? Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And just ask them, why did they rush towards Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala? Why did they go to him first? They went to him because they knew that he was a pillar and he was one of the biggest pillars of Islam. And they wanted to take him away. And if they had taken him, they thought that if they took him away, because he's a massive influence, if they took him away, what would have happened is that Islam would have come. This is what they thought. So they go to who? Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And so when they go to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, they say to him, do you know what your friend is saying? Do you know what your friend is saying? He's saying that he went all the way to Jerusalem, Bayt al-Maqdis. He went there in just a small part of the night and he came back. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala asked them, did he really say this? Did the Prophet really say this? And say, yes, he did. And they will be happy that, you know what, he might come to us. You know, he says that if he has said it, it is the truth. If he has said it, it is the truth. And shall I tell you something? That I believe in something which is even far beyond that. I believe an angel comes, a messenger comes from the seven heavens and comes to give messages to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so, it's mentioned that then this ayah was revealed. وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The one who has brought the truth, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ, and he who confirmed the truth, he who affirmed the truth, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, he affirmed the truth. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. And this is mentioned that they are talking about the companions radiallahu ta'ala, that they are from those who are God aware and God fearing. So this is the rank of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. And I mentioned that one of the reasons that the ulama kiram they mentioned is because of this companionship that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala had with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And another reason they mentioned is that love that he had for the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that love which cannot be reached is a love which was far beyond what we can think, what we understand as love. It was far beyond that. That love, that when there are many examples I can give about the love of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. It's amazing if you just look at the love that Sayyidina Abu Bakr and the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een they had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is just amazing. But one instance, I'm going to mention a few instances inshallah azza wa jal. But the love of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhum was such that one particular time the Quraysh they were about to be the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what happened was Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and tried to stop them. He came in the way. And he was beaten so much, hatta ke he's unconscious. And when he's unconscious, he's literally on the verge of death. And so the people, they take him home. And when they take him home, when he wakes up, what would be a natural reaction? What would we say? Where am I? What's happened to me? Am I okay? Or we wouldn't be able to talk. Something like that would happen. What does he say? He says, where's the Messenger of Allah? Is he okay? Is the Messenger of Allah okay? And the people around him, they say that, don't worry, he's okay, he's fine. Have something to eat, have something to drink. He says, no. I will not drink and eat until I see the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He didn't drink or eat until he saw the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is fine. And then the journey of Hijrah, the migration. Now that is a journey of love in itself. Where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is walking and sometimes Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and is rushing in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes he's rushing behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes he's rushing to the right of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sometimes he's rushing to the left of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asks him, oh Abu Bakr, what are you doing? He says, he replies to Allah Ta'ala, Ya Rasulullah, when I feel that someone may attack you from the front, I rush in front of you. When I feel someone may attack from behind, I rush behind you. When I feel someone may attack you from the right, I rush to your right and I rush to your left when I think someone may attack you from the left.
No.
As if he is circulating the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his love. And then when they come to the cave, he takes the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on top of the mountain. And he asks if he can enter in first. Because he wants to see if there's any harmful thing in there. So he goes inside, into the cave. And he sees holes, many holes. Some people say that there were 70 holes. So he sees all these holes. And so what he does is, with his garments, he fills them all in. So he fills in all these holes. And there's only one hole left. So what he does in that hole, he places his heel there. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes into the cave and they lay in the lap of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, they do not move and they are very wary and very cautious. Meanwhile, a snake comes. Now this snake comes and bites Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. Just think for a second, if something small was to bite us, let's say an ant, our natural reaction would be, we'd move our hand away. Because it hurts, it's stung. This is a snake biting and pumping its venom into the foot and the heel of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. But is he moving? No, he's not moving. Why is he not moving? Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is resting in his lap.
Subhanallah.
But if you look at it from the snake's perspective as well, let's change the story a bit. Let's look at it from the snake's perspective as well. Now, why is the snake biting? Why is it biting again and again? What's the reason for this? And Mia Muhammad Baksh rahimahullah ta'ala, and they say in Ashir, they describe this scene, they say, Aase, aase, umr guzari, tajalli qar hazara, mali baagh, na bekhande. Jadwaya Bahara. He says that the snake had very high hopes. This high hope that he wanted to see the best of creation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so he made all his life he's been, you know, making these holes just to see a glimpse of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so he makes these holes. And so he comes back to that place and he sees that all these holes, how many holes that he made, whether it's 70 or how many there were, they're all filled up. And it's only one flesh that you can see, one part of flesh that you can see. And he's thinking to himself, if I buy this, maybe then the person will move and I'll be able to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Well, this is the lowest he's going to be Akbar radiallahu ta'ala and himself. Now he does not move. This is the low of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, he doesn't move. And it's as if he's thinking to himself that, you know, my life is worthless compared to the rest of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Compared to the rest of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, my life is nothing. If it means that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can rest properly, I don't mind. And so, this love and this pain, it becomes a tear. And it falls onto the cheek of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I fall into the cheek of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't asleep. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was resting. And so the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh, look, look. And so what happened is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam placed the blessed slider on the heel of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. This is the love that Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and had for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the love that he had for the deen. Nobody could beat him in his actions. In whichever action that he did, he was the first. And he was always the first. And Allama Iqbal rahimahullah ta'ala, they write a poem regarding Sayyidina Abu Bakr and a waqia that takes place. So in this poem, they've amazingly painted a picture for us. And they show us the love that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala had for the deen and had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Ek din Rasool Paak ne ashab se kaha de maal raah haq mein jo ho tumne maaldaar. Ek din Rasool Paak ne ashab se kaha دے مال رائے حق میں جو ہو تم نے مالدار. ارشاد سن کے پڑھتے طرب سے عمر اٹھے اس روز ان کے پاس تھے درہم کئی ہزار.
Now that day, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, that give in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. Give in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. Whoever from you is wealthy, whoever from you has got money. After hearing this, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he became excited. He became excited, full of happiness. When we ask, or when someone asks us, give money for the masjid, you know, we hide and how did I go that way? Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, in excitement he gets up. And why does he get up in excitement? That day he's got many thousands of dinar, many thousands of dirham. He's got many thousands of dirham that day. So what does Allama Iqbal rahimahullah ta'ala say?
Dil mein ye keh rahe the ke Siddiq se zaroor bar kar rakhega aaj qadam mera rahbar laaye arz ke maal رسول امی کے پاس ایثار کی ہے دست نگر ابتدائی کار.
So what they do is that they're thinking to themselves, they're just thinking in their heart, they're thinking to themselves that today is the day that I'm going to be Siddiq Akbar. Today is the day that's going to be that day that I'm going to be in something at least. I've got thousands of dirham today, and today is the day that I'm going to beat him in giving sadaqah, and giving this in the way of Allah, I'm going to beat him today. And so he's excited, this competition Now, who can get in the way of Allah Ta'ala? And so he's excited because that day, you know, he's got many thousands of dirhams. You know, many thousands of dirhams. So that day he's very happy and excited that I'm going to give this in the way of Allah. I'm going to be Siddiqui Akbar, radiallahu ta'ala. So he brings all this money in front of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
Pooja huzoor se bade alam ne umar e wo ke josh haq se tere dil ko hai qarar rakha hai kuch ayal ki khatir bhi tu ne kya muslim hai apne khesh o اقارب کا حق گزار
The Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم asked Ibn Umar رضی اللہ تعالی that is there anything that you've left at home? Because it is a duty upon a Muslim that he looks after those people that he has a haq over, who he has a right over. He needs to look after them too. And what does he say? He says,
کی عرض نصف مال فرزند و زن کا حق باقی جو ہے وہ ملتے بیزاب نثار کی عرض نصف مال فرزند و زن کا حق باقی جو ہے وہ ملتے بیزاب نثار اتنے میں وہ ربی کے نبوت بھی آ گیا جس سے بنا عشق و محبت ہے اس دوار
So what does he say? He says, Ya Rasulullah, and what half of everything? Just think about this, half of everything, half of all his belongings. What does that mean? If someone has just, I'm not talking about the house, I'm not talking about the house. If he just has 100,000 pounds, giving 50,000 pounds in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal, was not Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, and didn't just do money. He did half of everything that he owned and he bought in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That day he said, you know, I'm going to be the winner today. I'm going to be the one who's going to be Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala. And in a narration that I heard, it's mentioned that then Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala is coming with a very smaller bag compared to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. What a massive bag! Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, he's brought a very small bag. He's carrying a smaller bag. And so Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he's getting happier. Now today is going to be the day. Today is going to be the day. I'll definitely win him today. And so he comes and he brings this bag into the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He opens it up.
لے آیا اپنے ساتھ وہ مرد وفا سرش ہر چیز جیسے چشم جہاں میں ہو اعتبار مل کے امین و درہم و دینار و رفت و جنس اسپ قمر سمو شدر و قاتل و حمار
Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala he brings everything that he possibly brought in this to my Abani he brings everything with him he brings his donkey whatever that he possibly could get his hands on that he told his value to it he bought them all in the court of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
بولے حضور چاہیے فکر عیال بھی کہنے لگا وہ عشق و محبت کا رازدار اے تجھ سے دیدہ ماں انجم فروغ گیر اے تیری ذات باعث تکوین روزگار
The Messenger of Allah asks him the same question. That have you left anything at home? Because obviously it's the duty of a believer to look after his family. Have you left anything at home? Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and he says, Ya Rasulullah, you are the one who the moon and the stars, they have taken their life from. The moon, because of you, time itself and days and the whole creation is created. You are the reason for the creation of this world. And before I mention the last year, I want to bring attention to adoration. That shows you the love of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. That one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was saying to his companion, the companion told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I love three things of this world. My wives, the fragrance of this world, and salah to be the coolness of my eyes. And so the companions radiyallahu ta'ala, they said their own things. Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu ta'ala, he said that I love the three things in this world. The three things that I love is to command to do good, to stop from evil, and also to clothe those who are clothed. And so Sayyidina Uthman ibn Ali radiyallahu ta'ala, the companions, they said their own. Well, what does Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala say? SubhanAllah, what does Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala say? He says that, Ya Rasulullah, I love three things of this world too. Ya Rasulullah, meri aankhon aur aapka chehra.
Subhanallah.
Anzur ila wajhika ya Rasulullah. That my eyes and your blessed face, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That I'll be looking at you, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let days go past, let nights go past. I just want to look at you, ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The love of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala. But the most beloved thing to him is to look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the second thing. He says that, Ya Rasulullah, sacrificing all my wealth for me, Ya Rasulullah. The third thing, to have family ties to Ya Rasulullah, to give my daughter in your wedding, in your marriage, Ya Rasulullah. If you just think about this, that all these three, they are about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and without a doubt, it seems like Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala literally revolves around the love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so, the shaykh says, پروانے کو چراغ بلبل کو پھول بس پروانے کو چراغ بلبل کو پھول بس صدیق کے لیے ہے خدا کا رسول بس The way a moth it goes towards the light, it goes towards the fire. And it is attached to the light. So if you take all these lights off and you switch one off and there's a moth, it will go rushing towards that light. If there's a fire, the moth will go into the fire. It'll become fana in the fire. A nightingale, it circles the flowers that it is next to. It stays with those flowers. It says, like that, for Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, for Siddiq, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is enough. And the Messenger of Allah is everything for Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala. So this is the love of Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu ta'ala. His love for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And so, after the passing away, a time when everybody is in a state of shock. We cannot imagine that time. That time, and how the companions felt with Allah ta'ala, we cannot imagine. Because they lost someone who meant everything to them. And literally everything. They went to war against their own family for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They sacrificed everything for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than anything. And it was as if that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became the purpose of their life. And we see this in many different instances. Sayyidina Talha radiallahu ta'ala in the battle, he becomes a human shield for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The love that the companions radiallahu ta'ala they had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An onlooker, as a wazir, he came to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he goes back to the Quraysh, he says to the Quraysh, oh Quraysh, I have been to many kings. I have been to Kisra, Qaisar. I have been to all of the kings. Many kings I have been to. But I have never seen people who love their king The way that the ashab of Muhammad, the companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the way that they look Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would spit, they would gather that spit and they would not let that spit touch the ground, they would wipe that on themselves. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would speak, they were eagerly listening. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say something, they would quickly hasten to do it. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing ablution, he says that when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing ablution, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it was as if that they are about to take their souls out for the droplets of water. This, the love that the companions radiallahu ta'ala had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we cannot really imagine at all how the companions radiallahu ta'ala they must have had. We cannot imagine that. Because we have not interacted with someone the way that the companions radiallahu ta'ala they loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because they were true in their word. Their love meant love. They truly loved the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We claim what we want, but we cannot even fulfill the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Just think to yourself that, okay, if we love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are we trying to make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam our role? Do we really see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a role? Do we really try to do all the actions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do? Do we try to follow his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is that what love is? For the companions and narrations upon narrations upon narrations that are mentioned about the love that the companions radiallahu ta'ala they had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So again, you cannot really imagine how the companions radiallahu ta'ala, how much they looked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so, when the companions hear this news, they are in the state of shock. In the state of shock. And so, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he walks in and he asks Ijaza and he sees the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says that he's fainted. He's in this deep faint. And then he comes out and he starts shouting. Now whoever says the Prophet is dead, whoever says that the Prophet has passed away, I will take off his head. I will take off his neck. Whoever dares to say that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has passed away, I will take off his head. And he shouts this and he's swinging around his sword. And then, sometime later, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, and they walk in the room full of rage. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala becomes silent. When nobody could control him, he becomes silent. All the companions radiallahu ta'ala, they listen. And the mahol, it changes. And maybe it was because of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala that we have our deen today. It's very possible that it was not for Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. That crucial time that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala came and saved the iman of everyone. Saved everyone. Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, who was the best friend. Everybody knew this. That the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was close to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and vice versa. There was no one like them, how close they were. Until they come to their senses. This is the love that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala had for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then when he becomes the first leader, the first leader of Islam, we see many, many events that took place. And one of the very things that we see in history and from the ahadith is that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, his kindness and his humility never stops. But Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, after leading the Fajr Jamaat, every day he would go into the desert. And he would go into the desert. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, one day they think that, okay, he goes into the desert after every Fajr Namaz, every single day. So one day he follows him and he goes to Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and goes into a house. And then when the sun rises, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala returns back. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, they go and they find out who this person is. And he's an old blind lady. And so Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala asks him, that you know who comes to visit the other city.
He keeps his name a secret from me.
Okay, so what does he do?
He comes in, he washes my clothes, he cleans my house, he grinds the wheat, and he makes breakfast. And he does this every single day. And then, in another narration, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu, after the passing away of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, one day Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala, his mind was still at a lady, the old lady that used to be there. So he goes, and you know, silently he goes and he cleans everything up, and he checks if everything's in order, and cleans and washes and everything. And then he is about to feed her. And when he feeds her, he says that, Ewatni, these are not those hands. Why are they not those hands? Because when he asks, how do you know that it's not the same person? He used to check before the heat of what he used to make me eat. He just pointed him off. The Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, the humility. Just look at the humility of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. After being Amirul Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers, he is still traveling into the desert. And he is going into the desert to an old woman who is blind, her house, and he is cleaning her and washing and making her breakfast. This is the humility of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And they showed, again, they showed their look for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They showed it. And they act upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They act upon the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the fullest. And that's what you call true look. So you can take many lessons from the life of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. One of those lessons that we talked about is suhbah, friendship. Keep good friends. Stay with good people. Stay with pious people. And inshallah, Allah ta'ala will make you pious. Second lesson is love. Love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not just by claiming, not just by saying. Because we can say, like I've said, hundreds of times, thousands of times. We can say again and again, fully out, we can say it. All day and all night. We love the Prophet. We can do nare, we can say this, that, other. But there's no action behind it. If we're not acting on the sunnah of the Prophet, if we're not coming to the masajid to read namaz, if we're not coming to read our salah, then what kind of love is that? When the Prophet said, that salah is the coolness of my eyes. Do we come to the masajid to read our namaz? Do we come to read salah? Or do we skip our salah? What do we do? Are we following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Are dear to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And if not, we need to make this change where we truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, truly learn and understand about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, act upon the way and the concept of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah ta'ala enable us to truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and truly understand the life and to look at the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the life of the companions radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who are all true role models. May Allah ta'ala enable us to truly take them as role models as well. Ameen wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Can everybody please stand up for us after salam to Jalakun al Maqib?
يا نبي سلام عليك يا رب عليك صلوات الله عليك يا نبي سلام عليك يا رسول سلام عليك يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات حشر میں سرکار آنا میرے عیبوں کو چھپانا اپنے رب سے بخشوانا ساتھ جنت میں بسانا یا نبی یا رسول سلام علیکہ يا حبيب سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك When I close my eyes eternally May your vision be my company though I'm far from worthy, but I'm blessed to be Ummati.
Ya Nabi Salam Alayka, Ya Rasul Salam Alayka, Ya Habib Salam Alayka, Salawat. سلام عليك صلوات الله عليك.
والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه. اللهم أرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. يا الله پاك مارين حاضر قبول منظور فرما. نبي پاك عليه الصلاة والسلام سنت عمل کرنے توفيق عطا فرما. يا الله سيدنا ابو بكر الصديق رضي الله تعالى عنه کی زندگی پر عمل کرنے توفيق عطا فرما. يا الله پاك ما دلوں میں تمام صحابہ کرام علیہم رضوان کے محبت نصیب فرما اور ان کے نقش قدم چلنے کی توفیق عطا فرما. سبحان ربک رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا رحمة الله. On your way.
Are you okay?
Good, yeah.
Yeah. Happy to be in Pakistan.
That's fine.